Hemsby on the East Norfolk coast is a classic old-fashioned seaside resort. Holidaymakers have been coming here for decades, but last winter it found itself at the centre of a seaside disaster. This sand dune is all that's between the North Sea and these houses behind me. Where I'm standing, where I'm walking, is all that remains of 183 The Marams in Hemsby. It used to be home to Jackie Connolly and her husband. Now, when I first met Jackie just before Christmas, none of us had any idea of what was about to happen.
BBC Radio Norfolk. Alex Dolan's here with the latest on the weather front.
Yeah, the concern over the next few hours is the storm surge, and it's being created by an air of low pressure.
Every day, Jackie Connolly dreads listening to the weather forecast.
We've also got very strong onshore winds.
What's predicted to happen tonight could literally change her life.
So this all coincides together with high spring tides, so spring tides.
Jackie's home is perched precariously on a cliff top. Over the years, the sea has eroded away the sand dune it sits on. A neighbour has already moved out, his house condemned. Jackie is concerned her home could suffer the same fate. How worried are you living here?
Very worried, because we don't know what the next storm's going to bring. You know, how bad it's going to get.
So do you ever go to bed thinking that, my goodness, if we have a bad storm tonight, we may wake up in the night and half the house is gone.
Yeah, might be homeless tomorrow. That's what I think.
Just look how close Jackie's home is to the edge. And it's not just her home here in Hemsby. The whole resort is fighting for survival. And when you get weather like this, storms that blow up, it's no wonder people here in Hemsby are really worried about their future. There are no sea defences protecting the village, and they've been refused public funding to build them. So they're doing it themselves.
Salute! Arm stretch! Arm stretch!
The fear of losing part of the village has brought the whole community together. As the storm rages outside, they've gathered for a fundraising evening at the pub. It'll add to the £20,000 they've already raised to pay for their own sea defences. Lorna, the whole community seems to be behind this.
We're absolutely 100% behind it. We're having fun and raising money at the same time. The community is dead set on enjoying.
Tonight we'll go directly into building new sea defences.
We absolutely will, yeah, every penny.
But while we're filming in the pub, outside, the storm surge is making its way down the north coast. The sea has burst through in the Norfolk village of Wells next to sea. The streets are underwater. Just down the coast, the pier at Cromer is next to be battered as waves engulf the beach and the prom. ...25 miles further along at Hemsby, none of us has any idea of the scale of the storm heading our way.
While we're standing here, the lifeboat hut is literally tipping into the sea. The high tide has chiselled away underneath the foundations, and it's literally tipping up as we're standing here.
So this one here is nearly gone, is it now?
Jackie and her husband Steve have been at the pub for the fundraising evening. They're concerned about their home. They've decided to go back to check everything's okay.
We've just come along Jackie's road, and the house next door, which has actually been condemned anyway, half of the house has gone. So it's just disappeared over the sand dune tonight in the high tide. What was it again? I forgot what it is now. I've lost my.
We carried on to see if Jackie and Steve's home was still safe.
Jackie's just going into the house now with her husband. Hang on, it's really close, it's really close. Hang on. Everyone stop. They're really close. The back of the house is gone.
Don't go too close to that, because that'll be very unstable. You can see what's going on in this paving slab.
What are we gonna do now? I can't believe this has happened.
What's happening now? What are you doing now? What's happened?
We don't know because we're not prepared for none of it. So.
Where will you go tonight? Was there somewhere you can go to be safe?
Well, there's only like people that's offered us somewhere like to stay for
this
the night.
Just, but it's absolutely kittens. Heartbreaking for you to come back and find
this. Yeah, I mean, you didn't expect it to go like this.
Can we go now? Gone.
Time is of the essence now. People from the village have come down to help Jackie and Steve move stuff out of their house before it goes over the edge. So they're grabbing anything they can and getting it out of the house. But the house just isn't safe.
Let's get the table out the door.
Come on.
That's enough now.
You need to prioritise now. Right. What is most important to you? You need to get out now.
Something else open.
Yeah. Seriously now.
They've now said that the house is not safe. They said they can hear it actually rocking at the back. Everyone's cleared of the house. Everyone's out. That's it.
Just as we go, we see the floor lifting. And what was Jackie's neighbour's house is carried away by the sea.
Take yourself to the pub, come on. Come on, darling, you'll be alright.
The next day, we returned to see the full extent of the damage. This is all that remains of the old lifeboat station. Just a few bricks. The rest, all washed away.
In daylight, you can see just how destructive the waves have been, and it's still so powerful this morning. The waves are still crashing on the beach here. This is as close as we can safely get to the sand dunes. If you look over there, you can see Steve and Jackie's house now down on the beach, and four other houses were lost last night. Jackie, looking at, I mean, this is just...
Yeah.
It's unreal.
That's the living room, that is. Yeah, it was, the living room.
What time did it go over last night?
Well, we don't know.
I just can't believe that's your house on the beach.
No, and I can't believe it either.
I mean, this is devastating, Jackie. You and your husband have lost your home.
Yeah, lost everything now.
To make matters worse, Jackie and Steve believe they're not covered by their home insurance. They've been given temporary accommodation in a nearby holiday camp. A week later, and work is busy going on to try to clear up the beach.
Pictures of these houses have been seen by people all around the world. But what most people probably don't know is that the sand dune actually came to here. They lost 30 feet of sand, and what's worrying is that more is predicted to go.
What struck me was how everyone had pulled together that night. But what happened is not easily forgotten. Many are now worried about the future of their homes too.
What's it like living here, Angela?
It's scary. It is really, really frightening. Go to work in the mornings and don't want to come home at night. This isn't home anymore. It's frightening to come home. Every night before I go to bed, I get my torch out and shine along the dunes to see if the dunes are still there. We've got a short bit of dunes left and then our homes go. And when our homes go, how much more of Hemsby goes with it?
Half a year has now passed since the storm. People here still fear for the future, but there's something else too. Determination. This is a community that refuses to give up.
Many people living here are right to be worried. The UK coastline is constantly being monitored, and predictions are made as to how things may look in the future. For Hemsby, if the predictions are correct, in around 100 years' time, this row of houses behind me may not even be here. They'll have been swallowed up by the sea.
But Hemsby is clearly a place people can't help falling in love with, and they'll defend it to the end. People like Del Darby, who runs the two-way cafe.
Can I have some clean water, please? Do you like Hemsby, though, don't you?
I love Hemsby.
Nearly as much as you like your cod and chips.
Del's a Cockney, and proud of it too. But a trip to Hemsby as a youngster changed his life forever.
God bless you. This looks like I've rehearsed all this, but I get this all the time.
Now I get it.
He moved here 16 years ago and has been running the cafe ever since.
Just put your money in the tip box after, I don't mind. I've been to Miami before, I've been to South. I've been all over the place, now South End. But when I looked at Hemsby Beach, I just was like, it was like climbing over a load of big mountains, and then you see this great big desert. This is the best beach I've ever seen. Still, better than the Algarve.
Okay, ladies, today's wedding. When they're seated down after the speeches, we're going to be going round and taking their meal orders.
To survive, the village needs thriving businesses. Laura runs the pub. Last time we met, she was raising money for sea defences. But business must go on, and today there's a wedding to prepare for. Like Del at the cafe, she wasn't born here, but soon grew to love the place.
I love Hemsby. It wasn't always that way. My father moved us here from London in 1977, and I hated him. Hated him for bringing me here.
Really? You didn't like it at all?
Not at all, no. It was so quiet, so different from what I'd been used to. I was 12 years old, but do you know what was the best thing he could ever have done
for me? So gradually you kind of came to fall in love with it, fall in love with the place, the people.
Absolutely. There's a charm about somewhere like Hemsby where people say hello to each other, they welcome you in, you're not afraid to look people in the eye, there's plenty to do, and if you're in trouble, everybody gets on board and they come and help you.
Every day the coast is changing and eroding away, and one day there will be another storm. The last great tidal surge was in 1953. Hundreds of lives were lost along the east coast. Seven people died at Sea Pawling, just a few miles north of Hemsby. As a result of the flooding, Sea Pawling got defences, and more have been built since. The government will only fund defences for places where the value of homes and businesses is high enough to justify the huge cost. Hemsby isn't considered valuable enough, so villagers are still trying to raise funds themselves. Laura's come to meet an erosion expert.
So at Hemsby, we've obviously got a lot worth saving. We have an 80 million annual industry there. A lot at stake. Is there something that we can do?
It's going to be very difficult. One's got to recognise that this is a very soft coastline. It's been eroding for the last 5,000 years or so, and a lot of the cliffs have been disappearing at an average rate of 1 metre a year. That's a lot of land we've lost. So a variety of solutions have been tried along here. We've used reefs, as we've seen here. We've got groins, we've got the seawall, we've got rocks put at the base of areas. We've got our natural defences like the sand dunes. So yes, there are a variety of measures that we can put in place. A lot of those are quite expensive. This defence probably cost about £65 million. And so at the end of the day, we've got to look at cost-benefit analysis. Now, what one's got to look at in the case of Hemsby and other areas like in the North Norfolk coast is what one's got to look at the economic advantages versus the costs of taking these various measures. And so just putting a wall in front of everything is one potential solution, but that destroys the nature of the coast.
It wasn't just people's homes that were destroyed by the recent storm surge. Hemsby's old lifeboat station was also a victim. I'm standing right where it was, and as you can see, there's pretty much nothing to suggest it was ever here. But we're not talking about a wooden shed. It's a huge concrete building that was destroyed that night. While we're standing here, the lifeboat hut is literally tipping into the sea. The high tide has chiseled away underneath the foundations, and it's literally tipping up as we're standing here. So, Dan, what do you remember about the night?
Well, obviously of the night of the high surge with the sea coming in, battering the coastline. Obviously the station at the time was being undermined. And then potentially the shed just started to lean and obviously just broke up in pieces. Just amazing.
Could you believe what you're actually seeing? I mean, the lifeboat station was huge. It wasn't a small shed.
No.
Could you believe that it was being tipped into the water like a
No,
a
I couldn't. No, I just couldn't. You know, machinery, you'd need machinery to break something like that up, and for the sea just to do it within a couple of hours, and yeah, it was unbelievable. I've never personally seen the sea like that before. I've seen it bad, but that was really bad. There was waves probably 30, 40 foot in the air. It's just, yeah, it's just dangerous.
In Independent of the RNLI, the lifeboats run by volunteers. Typically for Hemsby, the villagers raise the £30,000 a year to keep that going themselves. Fortunately, the lifeboat and equipment was moved out of the old building before the storm carried it away.
We're about 40 or 50 feet off the shore here at Hemsby. What's quite hard to get your head round is that 50 years ago, there would have been a sand dune where we are. In fact, two or three sand dunes have gone between where we are and what you can see now. And it's reckoned there were around 70 beach chalets and houses that were here that have just been lost to the sea. So beneath the boat, beneath where I'm sitting, could have been somebody's home. It's quite a thought.
There's a long history of people losing their homes here. Dell's family first came to Hemsby back in the early 90s. They loved the place, and his dad decided to buy a beach house overlooking the sea. But it wasn't long before things went terribly wrong.
Believe it or not, our first place, which is about 20 years ago, when we came down from East London, my dad bought my mum at one of these beach houses. And it was situated, if you just vaguely see the grass.
Oh yeah, you see the grass poking out the sand, middle, yeah.
That would have been another dune again.
That was the dune, that's where it was.
Yeah.
So basically, where we are now, another half again, before you got to the sea.
And when we got it, we was 25 foot away from the edge and thought, nothing, how lucky we are to have a beautiful sea view.
Now that wonderful position.
I've run on this beach, I see seals in the water. It was beautiful, and I'm fast. I thought, bloody hell, this is so lovely. And then, like, in two, 3 days of high tides, my mum's house, 20th anniversary, bosh, in the sea.
So how long had you had the property before it went into the sea?
3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Ideal home, and within 3 weeks, from being 20 feet away from the edge, it was in.
So how'd it come back to here now? So it was on...
That's at least how much we've lost in the 20 years that I know of.
Yeah.
She decorated it all, her curtains she made, and then just see it floating away in the sea. She was so proud telling people that she'd lived on by the sea. Not by the sea, with a lovely sea view. She'd look out her kitchen window, and she'd be looking at that picture there, which is beautiful.
Despite the fragile nature of the place, there are plenty of people who are put off by the threat of disappearing over the edge. This house, just yards from the sea, is on the market for £35,000. I bumped into Paul Atfield, who's thinking of buying it.
It's in too bad condition, is it, really?
No, it looks a lot sturdier than I was hoping.
Do you know how long it's been here?
I don't, I'm afraid.
No? Have they not said when it was built?
No, I think sort of turn of the century is what I'm hoping for it to be newer, obviously.
Yeah.
From my point of view, but it looks pretty watertight, just wants some love.
So are you looking to buy this as your main home, or?
No, I'm looking at it more as a holiday home and something to play with at the weekends. And
I mean, despite what's happening here, I mean, you've got coastal erosion, you know, coastal surge, houses were lost here, and you're prepared to invest in this?
It's quite scary, but I think it'll be fun for the children.
So this is your back garden, or would be?
Would be the back garden. I suppose the verge must be...
That must be the boundary, mustn't it?
Yeah. But it's sort of a bit like Wild West, I think. What you're prepared to take and hang on to and maintain.
Yeah.
Sort of becomes yours, really.
So if you bought this place, you'd be pretty close to the sea. I mean, it's right there. Are you still convinced it's the place you want to take a punt on?
Not 100% convinced, but it's a flip of the coin. And I think... It's what the risk is worth it for the pleasure I intend to get out of it. Just a definite flip of the coin. Yeah.
But it could only be 10, 15 years, that's enough for you, is it?
Obviously I'd like more.
Yeah.
But
you may get more.
I may get more. But I think I'd be hurt if it's any less than 15 years.
Okay.
White line, payroll fines, 55. Green, 601,
Business owners in Hemsby, like Lorna and Dell, are worried that the storm and pictures of houses in the sea have damaged the reputation of the resort. Tourism is essential to their survival, so they're hoping a marketing expert can come up with some ideas.
Yeah, I mean, there must be 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 jobs that reliant on this area. If you spread it out to the holiday camps, the chalet sites, local businesses.
We're not just looking at sort of defending the coast, we're actually looking at making Hemsby nice. We're looking at maybe painting, you know, murals on old disused toilet blocks. We're looking at planting marram grass.
You have to remember, and the traders of Hemsby have to remember, none of this was your fault. It wasn't like it was a bad town. It's that you were the victim of weather and climate and tides. And you need to kind of move on from that because there are so many positive things to say about this place.
So how do you suggest we tell the two different stories? Because there's one story around Hemsby still needs help, and the other story, but it's still open for business and it's doing great. So how do we tell the two stories?
That's a really good question. I think it's a perfect combination of story, actually. It's really interesting listening to you two talk about the enthusiasm you've had about the Save Hemsby coastline, because what's significant about the fact you've had all of that support is that people believe it is worth saving. It's not like, oh, it's only Hemsby. It's, in fact, it's what a fantastic resort with long tradition of people, families coming over generations and generations, with a wonderful landscape, seascape. And I think those two things go together. I think it's, tell the story about how what a fantastic place it is for a holiday or to visit, and say, oh, and by the way, you realise this is a kind of frontier town in the sense that out there is the sea. And if you love this as much as we do, or half as much as we do, help us to preserve it. And I think it's almost a perfect combination.
Good publicity alone won't save Hemsby. After the storm, this was what remained of the defences put on the beach by Lorna and the other villagers. The huge waves that night tore them out of the sand. Undeterred, today the residents of Hemsby are back to put down another line of rocks.
The rocks arrived. People are just, you know, digging in and getting the blocks filled.
So loads of people are helping out here, Lorna. Is this the way it's been working over the last few months, that people just come up, they volunteer, they give their time freely to build your own kind of defences?
This is what Hemsby is all about, community, people getting together, doing it for ourselves. There's no way we're going to sit back and wait for somebody to take action. If we wait, we could wait too long. These dunes are too important. They need protecting now. So we're just getting on with it. We'll keep putting in for our bids to the government, but in the meantime, we'll do the protection that we can.
Do you live in Hemsby?
No, we're holidaymakers, and we came up 2 years ago and then saw everything on the telly December, and then came up this year for fortnight sidings, amazed where everything is. So we saw the poster, so thought just, you know, give a hand, try and tidy things up a bit.
Something's got to be done. Nobody else is not bothered, so it's got to be done to the beat, otherwise it all just go. You know, and it's a shame because it's such a lovely place.
The happy wedding couple are married. Church service over, it's time to head for the beach for some photos.
Why Hemsby?
I've just spent many childhood holidays here, and it feels like a second home to me.
And it's the first place we holidayed together as well. So
even though you live in Essex, this was your first choice, was it? You both said, hey, let's get married in Hemsby. It means so much to us.
Yeah, absolutely means the world. Well, I absolutely love Hemsby. I'd come here every year. Well, I think we come here every year anyway. I think it is just where I used to come here as a kid. It's just...
So lots of happy memories.
Very happy memories.
And now you've got married here as well. Yeah. As special as that. So Hemsby will always be very special to you now, and even more so. Well, congratulations.
All I can say is
congratulations. May I kiss the bride?
You can.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. Hope you have a lovely day.
Thank you very much.
But there's one couple for whom the love affair with Hemsby is certainly over. After they lost their home last December, Jackie and Steve Connolly moved away. They've come back today for the first time since that dramatic night.
I don't know if you can cast your mind back. I know it was a very traumatic evening for you and everybody along this entire June, wasn't it? It was a very traumatic evening back in December. What can you remember the most? What do you remember about it?
I don't know, really.
I remember coming up and it's just a shock, you know. I've seen it go like it did. Just, you know, I just didn't expect it. But even you didn't.
No. I think the first time when I realised it was getting serious was when the lifeboat station was tipping into the water.
Yeah.
And then, but even at that point, when I came to see you in the pub and I said, we walked down your road, I actually thought at that point, it'll be fine.
Yeah.
There's no way Jackie and Steve's house will be in danger.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we came round and the back had gone, hadn't it?
Yeah, the back had gone and the water had
gone underneath.
And it was just rushing round, you know, it's something you never want to see again.
Is it easy coming back? How do you feel as you
No, it's not easy coming back. No, I say the only reason we're back is because of you. Yeah. I mean, otherwise, we'd never come back here.
No.
I don't ever intend to come back here again.
But people here obviously rallied round to help you at the time.
Yeah.
You couldn't, I remember you couldn't
so
quite believe
good.
How people were.
Yeah. Yeah, that everybody was so good.
Said up to that night, we knew about five people by name.
I mean, because we kept ourselves to ourselves and we never bothered, like, you know, we sort of said hello to people across from us.
We knew half the village.
And that night, I couldn't believe where all the people came from.
But there is a happy ending. At the time, Steve and Jackie were worried they wouldn't get any compensation and be able to afford to buy another home. But fortunately, they discovered although their insurance didn't cover them for erosion, they were covered for storm damage. It's meant a new start, not in Hemsby, but far from the sea, in Rotherham.
So this is where you live now?
Yeah, that's it now.
That's great. Two big bungalow.
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing how fate has actually ended you up in a better position?
Yeah.
Almost. I mean, I know you went through the tragedy.
Yeah.
And you went through the trauma of losing your home.
Yeah.
But you managed to, you couldn't sell your property here.
No.
You've had your payout. You've moved up north.
Yeah.
And you've got a job.
Yeah.
You know, isn't that amazing how your life has been turned around because of that?
Yeah.
Look at this. This is beautiful. On a day like today, very easy to forget just what it was like 6 months ago. But when I first came back to Hemsby, I kind of expected to find people pretty fed up. And you would expect that considering what had happened to them. But I found the opposite. Everyone's come together. Everyone's working really hard to make sure that they save their seaside. So I know it sounds cliche, but through adversity, it's brought people closer together. And I think that's what's special about Hemsby. They will carry on here no matter what the North Sea has to throw at them.